Hey everybody, I wanted to share something that comes with, at least for me, with living off-grid. There's kind of this balance for myself with this feeling of having everything and nothing all at the same time. The everything is knowing that we are so immensely blessed to be on this property. This is something that I have dreamt about since I was a child. I have always wanted a large piece of property with the trees and the creeks and everything like that. And up until very recently, I didn't know if that would ever even happen. And God has just blessed us immensely there. So I know that by being on this property, there's a huge blessing upon my family's lives. But then with the off-grid thing, there's the whole balance of having nothing. So we are not hooked up to electricity. We're not hooked up to water. So we are doing generator and battery power. And then for water, a lot of times it's 55-gallon drums of water. And that's, you know, filling it up at campgrounds and stuff like that. And there's not a problem with that. Like, that's perfectly fine. And we knew that coming in, or I knew that coming into this property, that that's the way it was going to be. So, I'm fine with it. Like, it truly does not bother me. Like, I'm totally cool. It makes things a lot easier, actually. There's a lot less stress on mine and my husband's life. And the fact that we have, like, barely any bills is absolutely fantastic. But there's still that balance of, for me, and I really had kind of like almost like a little bit of a breakdown the other day about, like, how are we going to be able to build a house? As many of you know, lumber prices are through the roof. There's been some alternative things that my husband and I have talked about doing that still would be much cheaper than building with lumber, but still be kind of pricey and time consuming. So it's one of those things where we know it's not the time yet, but at the same time, it's, you know, something we do think about and talk about occasionally. And so I kind of had a little bit of a breakdown about it because I had that whole, how is this even going to happen thing? And then, yet again, I had to have that check in myself because this property is evidence of that right there. If someone had told me even 2 years ago that we would have a property like this, I would have probably laughed at them and been hopeful, but I would have probably laughed at them. So knowing that we even got this property, I know that we will have a house eventually, and it'll be in the timing that is set forth by God. So I know that, but I'm still human, so I still get those moments of like, oh my gosh, how are we gonna do this? And so that's where my husband's been great about kind of keeping me in check too. He's more steadily, emotionally steady at times than I am. But it was ironic because the same night that I had that kind of like breakdown about how is this going to happen, a puppy showed up on our property at 2:30 in the morning. And we live on 40 acres. 40 acres is basically the minimum around here for what people have for property. There's no towns. Maybe 5-10 minutes down the road is probably the closest town, maybe even 15 minutes. So it's one of those things where it's like, this puppy didn't just like wander over here from the next door neighbors, because we did ask our neighbors and it's not theirs. We have 20 acres of mountain behind us and 20 acres of pasture in front of us where our camper's at right now. So how this puppy got within 50 feet of our camper is a mystery to us, especially since we have four large dogs on, well, two large and two medium-sized dogs on our property already. But we heard them going ballistic at about 2:30 in the morning, and then we heard this screeching, barking sound. And our first thought was that our mixed hound dog, that she had started getting in a fight with a coyote. So we come running outside being prepared to kill a coyote and save our dog. But it turns out that there was a puppy in one of our brush piles. And like I said, I have no idea how that puppy got there. It's a Great Pyrenees puppy. It's a little black puppy. It's adorable. Maybe about 10 weeks old. And we have two white Great Pyrenees already that we've had for about 6 years already. And so we knew immediately, seeing the puppy, its body type, the different things are very specific to the Great Pyrenees breed. We knew that it was a Great Pyrenees. And if you know anything about Great Pyrenees are also rather expensive to get as a puppy. We were blessed when we got our two grown Great Pyrenees when they were 2 years old. For a very, very good deal, actually. But they're not cheap. And so seeing that, that blessing that God kind of gave us of the puppy, which, like I said, we've checked for owners and there's no one to be found that's missing a puppy. It's one of those things where you know, we can't afford a Great Pyrenees puppy right now. We weren't even looking for a puppy. We already have four dogs. But it's one of those things where it's, you know, JT and I have talked in the past about eventually getting another Great Pyrenees puppy. As our Great Pyrenees are getting older, so we want to start training a younger one to watch our sheep for us. And it was kind of a reminder to me, like, you know, this property is a daily reminder of God's grace and God's love for our family. But at the same time, it's that I still had that, you know, weak human moment where I kind of broke down about how are we going to do a house. And God reminded me with a puppy saying, it's okay, I got you. Like, you know, he's given us this beautiful little boy dog that does need some help with his health because he does have worms, so we already have him on dewormer. He's a blessing to our family and a reminder that God provides regardless. And the name that kept coming to me for this puppy was Ezra. And Ezra in Hebrew means help or helper. And I just thought it was so beautiful because this puppy is a reminder of God's help to our family, not only in the sense of providing us with a future Great Pyrenees that we'll raise up to watch our livestock and everything else, but he did help the puppy by saving its life through us, and that he will provide regardless, and that this puppy will be a daily reminder to me of God's help and God's grace, and that he's got us, and I just got to be patient. Like, I can't try to push through and you know, want a house before a house is ready for us. We are blessed with the camper we have, so that's going to be it for a while, but we just got to keep praying and keep working towards that point, and that when it is the right time, God will provide, just like apparently it was the right time for us to have a puppy. So I hope y'all enjoyed that little bit of a story and you know, took something out of it for yourself as well. But hope y'all have a great day. Bye.